Welcome to Whiteboard Programming, where we simplify programming with easy to understand whiteboard videos. And today I'll be sharing with you the difference between encryption, encoding, hashing, and obfuscation, as all these are kind of similar terms for many people and are often confused with each other in the cybersecurity world. So let's get started. Number one, encoding. In a nutshell, encoding is all about data representation to enable information exchange and does not involve keeping secrets. The purpose of encoding is to transform data so that it can be properly and safely consumed by a different type of system. For example, binary data being sent over the email or viewing special characters on web page. Further, in encoding, security is not the primary concern, as it usually uses publicly available algorithms for transforming the data format, and these algorithms can be easily used to transform encoded data back into its original form. Broadly speaking, encoding is quite common practice, as by using it, the size of audio and video files can be reduced and each audio and video format like .mp4, .mp3, .avi, etc. is associated with a specific coder decoder or a codec program that is used to code it and then decode it for playback. American Standard Code for Information Interchange or ASCII is a common encoding scheme for files with text. And some other examples of encoding schemes include Unicode, URL encoding, and Base64. Next, number 2, encryption. The purpose of encryption is to transform data in order to keep it secret from others. For example, encryption is used if you are sending someone a secret letter that only they should be able to read, or if you want to securely send a password over the internet. Here, rather than focusing on usability, the goal is to ensure that data cannot be consumed by anyone other than the intended recipients. Further, the data to be encrypted, also known as plain text, is transformed using an encryption algorithm like AES encryption or RSA encryption using a secret key called cipher. The output here is the encrypted data, which is also called as ciphertext. And finally, the secret key can be used by intended recipients to convert it back to the plain text. Moreover, there are primarily two types of encryption algorithms, symmetric and asymmetric encryption. In the case of symmetric encryption, data is encoded and decoded with the help of same key, for example, AES encryption algorithm, but in the case of asymmetric encryption algorithm, data is encrypted with the help of two keys, namely public key and private key, and the example for this include RSA algorithm. Next, number 3, hashing. Now, hashing serves the purpose of ensuring data integrity. That is, making it so that if something is changed, you can know that it has changed. Technically, hashing takes any input of arbitrary length and produces a fixed length string that has the following attributes. First, the same input will always produce the same output. Second, any two unique inputs should never produce the same output. Third, it should not be possible to gain input or original data from output, as hashing itself is a one-way cryptographic function and is irreversible. And last is that any modification in a given input should result in drastic change to the hash. Further, hashing transforms a string of characters into a value of fixed length. This generated value is called hash. And as a concept, hashing is used in conjunction with authentication to provide strong evidence that a given message has not been modified. Here, when a message is sent, a hash of the message is also sent along with it. And at the receiving end, the same hashing algorithm is applied to generate a hash. Now, if both the hashes are identical, then it can be confirmed that the message has not been tampered with. But if it's not, then you know that whatever you received isn't the original data. This technique is also used in storing data. For example, passwords are hashed and stored in the database, and when the password is entered during the next login, the entered password is hashed, and this hash is compared against what is stored in the database. And if both the values are identical, then the access is granted. Some of the widespread applications of hashing techniques include blockchain and indexing, and some of the examples include SHA-3 and MD5. Next one on the list, number 4, obfuscation. The purpose of obfuscation is to make something harder to understand, usually for the purpose of making it more difficult to attack or to copy. One such application of this is obfuscation of source code, so that it is harder to replicate a given product if it is reverse engineered. Further, it is important to note that obfuscation is not a strong control like properly employed encryption methods, but rather an obstacle like encoding, and can often be reversed by using same technique that obfuscated it, and some of the other times it is simply a manual process that takes time to work through. Another key to realize about obfuscation is a limitation to how obscure the code can become. It also depends on the content being obscured. If you're obscuring computer code, for example, the limitation is that the result must be still consumable by computers, or else the application will cease to function. Some of the examples of this include JavaScript obfuscator and ProGuard. Lastly, as a summary, I would like to provide you with Twitter versions of each, so you may have better understanding of encryption versus encoding versus hashing versus obfuscation. So let's summarize it. Encoding is for maintaining data usability and can be reversed by employing the same algorithm that encoded the content, and here no key is used. Encryption is for maintaining data confidentiality and requires the use of a key which is kept secret in order to return to plain text. Hashing is for validating the integrity of the content by detecting all modifications thereof via obvious changes to hash output. Obfuscation is used to prevent people from understanding the meaning of something and is often used with computer code to help prevent successful reverse engineering and theft of a product's functionality. With that, I hope this video was helpful to you and served value. If you love my content, feel free to smash that like button, and if you haven't already subscribed to the channel, please do, as it keeps me motivated and helps me create more content like this for you.